Hey guys, it's Crystal13 here, bringing you another part of Let's Learn Hearthstone Arena. So in the last part, basically, I drafted this really good Paladin deck. It's fantastic, it has two legendaries, it has Onyxia and Hogger, and yeah, I just went 1-0 with it. I won my first game versus a Shaman. If you didn't see that, if you didn't see the first part, I drafted and played a game. So hopefully, we'll keep going strong with this. As I said in the last part, the only problem with this deck is it doesn't have great removal, so I'm going to have to trade really well and keep control of the board, which kind of sucks, because I can't say they played a 2-drop, which has 2 HP, and I'll ignore it, because I have a Consecration in the turn after. I'm going to have to trade into it. But at least our mini quality is fantastic. So yeah, we'll see. So, Warrior. People say Warrior is one of the weakest. Like one of the weaker. Oh my god! One of the weaker classes in Arena. So hopefully we'll have a great good game versus this. So this is our late game card. Definitely not gonna keep this. Kazan Mystic is useless versus Warrior since they have no secrets. And Aldor Peacekeepers is a situational card that you don't want to keep. So I'm gonna keep the Soul Splinter Trog. It's a great 2-drop, and hopefully we get our 1-drops, or we get all our 2-drops. Okay, so probably gonna coin out this. Since we got 4 2-drops, whoa, that's kind of, wow, okay, that's never happened before. So I'm gonna coin out this. I mean, what's the point of keeping the coin since we have so many 2-drops, so might as well start aggressing now. That's actually kind of funny. So probably next turn I'll put this down or this. Mind if I roll weed? So I think I'm gonna put this down. Trog, no, stupid. So, what do I trade here? I'd like to trade. But if he has cleave or something, that'd be kind of weak. But if he hits and then cleaves, this thing still lives. But then if he cleaves this thing, I'll have a 2-3, 2-1. Or would I rather have a 2-2? If he cleaves, this trades into that, or this trades into that, I'll have a 2-1 anyway. So I'm gonna trade anyway. Because at least it doesn't have board control and I have the initiative. Because if he cleaved this first, it'd either have a 2-1 and then he trades, or a 2-1 or a 2-2 and then he trades and I have a 2-1. So I don't know. It's either have a 2-2 or a 2-1, which is kind of awkward. Like this, he has to deal with both of them. And I have a 2-1 anyway. So yeah, I saw the cleave coming. So, and now I have 3-1 actually, since this has spells. So does he have any way of dealing with this? No, he doesn't. So, oh, that's a really good draw. Okay, so Footed Doctor is fantastic. And I think I'm gonna play this and put it right in the middle. So as of that, see, for all of you Voodoo Doctor haters, it just was fantastic. Cause this is now a 3-3. Oh, that was such a good draw. Okay, so that's annoying. So does he have a weapon? Yeah, he has a weapon. Now he has to take 3 damage to the face. Okay. Oh, I could recombobulator, which I don't really like. I don't really like anything here, because to be honest, this just dies and then trade and then it hits it. I don't think I have any other option besides recombobulating, so I'm just gonna play this. I could be super greedy and pass and then hit, but I don't know, do I want to pass? He could buff this, and that's super annoying. But then he could trade like simply into this and then hit that and I have one. No, I think I'm just gonna do this. And I'll play this as well. Yeah, put this here. Then he has the choice of picking either killing this or killing this. So, I don't know. This could have been a misplay playing this, but it's just so weird to have this 3-1 and the 1-1. If he has a whirlwind, that would be great for him since it kills everything and then he can trade. Oh no, that's not good. That's not good. Oh god. Oh god. Bomber, please. Bomber and fan. Oh, thank god. Okay. Oh, well, this gives what? Oh, okay. This is a really good card. It gives 3... What? That was... Wow, that voice crack. And now he's going to trade everything. Is he going to trade everything? Yeah, I would trade everything. Basically, if you summon a 3-drop with 3 attack or less, it gives it charge. So I'm just going to drop the Yeti here. No point playing the Argent. I'm going to have to kill this. This is really threatening. It's not good keeping it alive. I have to kill it. It's a really good card. Oh no. Oh god. That is awful. I have literally no way of killing that. Oh no. No, actually you can do that and kill it. Avenge then. Okay. I think I'm gonna play this. Kill it. Hero power and then avenge. I think that was the best I could do. I could recombobulate or something, but it's kind of a waste in my opinion. He does have a significant card advantage over me. But let's see what he does. If he kills this, it might avenge this. Or if he kills this, it will avenge this. I don't know, we'll see. This has to die, so probably next turn I hit that and hit it. Depends what it does. Hopefully not another taunt, which sucks. Armor. Oh no. That's such a good card. Armor Smith is so good. Oh god. Oh no. Plus 2 attack and charge, okay. He's gonna kill this, okay. But that's gonna get avenged to something. Okay, avenge. That's great actually that landed on that. Who's not gonna kill that? Or I can kill this. Oh god, that sucks. I have to kill this. But I have to kill this more. Oh god, I don't know which to kill. What are the odds that he has a 2-3 that is another 3 attack minion? I'm gonna be greedy and kill this. I have to kill that. If he gets too much armor. So now I'm gonna play Lord of the Arena and go phase. And then later if he hits this some more I can recombobulate it. So cool. Because this is a 6 drop. There are better things too. Okay, silence. So I can recombobulate that anyway. Okay, so what's gonna do now? He's gonna kill that. Then he's gonna go face again. Okay. Or I can silence that and kill that. Decision. Because this is a 2-3, that's a 4-3, that's way more threatening. So I think I'll do this. Farewell. Or yeah, I have to do this. Farewell. I can't kill anything with this, which sucks. This is kind of useless right about now. Yeah, I think I'll do this. Recombobulate it. Oh wow, that is way better. Holy crap, okay. And then I'll silence that. And then I'm gonna go face and hero power. So now we're in a fantastic position. He has no cards, he has 2 cards now to kill this. If you draw an execute, that sucks. But this is really good. That was such recombobulator value. Holy shit, that was so good. Mech Bearcat is fantastic. Okay, so that's fine. I'm gonna kill that. So I think I'm gonna clear the board now. Can he hit here? That doesn't die. What does he have in his hand? Oh, another fiery war axe, and he wasted that. Holy shit, he wasted the thing. Oh, he's gonna kill this. 7 damage to the face. Whoa. And I get a spare part, which is great. Oh, and I can take this back. Hopefully, he lets me. Oh, he's not gonna let me. Okay. So I think I'm just gonna trade here, hit here, take that, and And I could give this taunt, so he's forced to hit it. Oh, that's so good. Okay, I'll give that taunt. Our hand is kind of awkward, so just gonna play an Ardor Peacekeeper, since I just want to aggress as much as possible. It's kind of a waste if you see it like that, but he has no cards, so I think I won this one as well. Oh, that's so good. I'm so happy. Slam. Okay, he's gonna draw a card. I think he might be looking for a whirlwind, to be honest. Ah, okay. So we won. Well played. That recombobulator was so fantastic. I think that recombobulator basically won us the game. Okay, so we're going strong. 2-0. So hopefully we can keep the streak going. I don't know how much wins this might get. It's a really great deck. Like I keep saying over and over, the lack of removal will be a problem. Like if someone gets a really head early, well they can't since I have such a good early game. If they keep flooding over and over again, then that's how they could win, or they can rush me down. But I do have good healing also, so we'll see. Okay, so Druid is also as a great class also. I do want to keep this, even though it's such a situational card. I don't think I want to keep it, actually. It's a really good card, but it's so situational. If I don't get any 2 drops, it would suck. I'll keep it. I'll be greedy and keep it. I'll have a lot of 2 drops. Okay, good. So yeah, I'll Fae Dragon, then hit put that on that. put the Argent Protector on that. I have 3 one drops. Why do I not keep getting the one drops? God, Mulligan, why do you do this to me? Okay, let's see. Okay, that's a really crappy draw, but you know. Okay, hopefully it doesn't play anything. That would be fantastic, since I have Fairy Dragon. But even if he plays something, I have coins, a 2-drop, I have this, so it's fine. And doesn't die to his hero power, and doesn't die to Wrath, so this is a great draw. Recombobulator! How are you doing, man? I could also recombobulate Hogger. Since Hogger, like, if it gets, like, down in HP, I could recombobulate it. It is also a 6-drop, so, yeah. There are plenty of really good 6-drops. So yeah, you can Divine Shield that and hit it. That's great. See, this is such a powerful card. It's so broken. I hate facing paladins. And trade. Such good value. I keep minion board. I keep minion control. I have initiative to trade. I also have Alder Peacekeeper if something. If I want to kill something that has a high HP, but probably next turn just draw a card and slow down, I guess. Yeah, he's in an awkward position to be in, so let's see. Oh, that's a good answer. That's actually a good answer, since both of these have to go into it. But I don't think I'll do that. I actually think I'll go face. Wait, is he going to coin out a 1-drop? He has a coin still. He hasn't used it. Oh, I think he'll save it. Okay, saving it. So that must mean he's a 1-drop. Oh, that's really good. That's really good. That's a great draw. So put that there. No point in trading. I just lose board control. I could have traded and kept this. But I don't know. Maybe if he buffed that would be a mistake. But I do have this to catch up anyway. So, yeah. Let's keep that. But I think I could have traded. I probably should have traded. Because if he, like, buffs this, then it kind of sucks. I could be really greedy and take the Aldor Peacekeeper that. I think he has a buff. 5, maybe he has the, what's it called, the Druid with Claw. Oh, Sludge Belcher, okay. So yeah, I'm getting probably, oh, Innervate into a 2-drop. Oh, so that's a really good card also. Okay. Oh, Coghammer, that's also really good right here. So I could Coghammer and hit with the one that gets a Divine Shield. Or Coghammer and hit and hit. And then if this gets a Divine Shield, I can hit it. That's kind of awkward. I wonder. Or you could, like, Ardor Peacekeeper and trade both of these into that. But that's so weak. I think I'm just gonna play this. okay, that kind of sucks. So I have to put Poop. So Bam Bam. And that's a 1-2. Or I could Bam Bam Bam. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Bam. Bam. And then hit it. And then hero power. Since none of his cards deal with this, he has half a silence. And since this trades efficiency on to all of them. So that is actually fine. If he has a swipe that sucks donkey ass, that was probably the worst thing about this. It's so weak to swipe. Since he swipes here, that does 4 damage and then hits with this since he wants that to die. Yeah. But you know. But what is the other option? Like putting the hitting first, or like not hitting it at all? That'd be so awkward. Since he has the initiative, then. And next time I want to play Hogger anyway, so let's see. Swipe. Yep. Swipe value. Yep. That sucks. That sucks. Yeah. That was the worst case scenario. Okay. So I think we're gonna Hogger. I'm gonna Hogger and kill one of the 1-1s. I don't really have much else to play, but I could have gnomished and recombobbed or something, I don't know. But I think I'm gonna recombob this. I can hit here, hit with my face, and then recombob later maybe? I don't know, we'll see. And do a better 6-drop? Or I could Blessing of Kings. Blessing of Kings was also play on curve. It's a nice big dude. Oh, another swipe! Holy crap, this dice deck is so good. Jesus. Okay, so then I could Blessing of Kings and then recombobulate that. I hate this card, it's so good. I could not kill it. Yeah, I'm gonna just Blisk of Kings. I mean Guardian of Kings. Then pass. And see what it does from there. And then I could hit it. And hit it, and then recombobulate it, I guess. We'll see. Two swipes. I mean, he can't have another swipe. That would be so annoying if he has another swipe. Because then he'll swipe it and hit it. But that's highly unlikely. Especially since it took so long to do the first one, and then the second one so instantly. So we'll see. We are behind, since he has board. No, actually, we have a better board than he does, but we are still kind of behind. Since we're reacting to his plays. Or technically, he's reacting to us, since he's always clearing. We'll see. He is one turn away from Iron Barks, which sucks, since I really have no way of dealing with those. Let's see. Oh my god, it's so hot in here, Jesus. You have another Belcher? So annoying. Oh my god. So it hits straight, and then hits with my face. So annoying. Why did it take. I hate these taunts. This is probably my most annoying card ever. So, I'm gonna draw a card. Light Spanner. Ooh, Seal of Light. Kind of useless. So, I could this Seal of Light. What does that do? So, this plus Seal of Light, that would make that a 3-4. And then I could hit it. Okay, what does that accomplish? Then, this would be free to rain.
I wonder.
But if I do this, this would be a 5, what? 5, 3. And then he can trade one of these in. I think, do I want to be fancy? I could be fancy. I'm going to be fancy. And then hit it. I think this is the best place, so I keep massive board control. Let's see. That might have been a mistake. We'll see. Well, I dealt with it so efficiently. I liked it. So, we'll see. I like that play. That's literally the only spell that can proc Wild Pyro. Poor Wild Pyro. It's such a good card. Sucks that I didn't get any spells. Like, Consecrate. This plus Consecrate is fantastic. This plus Equality is so broken. Jesus, it basically kills everything on their board. Like, if they flood, then put this Equality and it kills everything. So good. That's great. Does he have an answer to this? He probably has an Iron Bark. I mean, his deck is so crazy. I'm assuming he has an Iron Bark. Oh, that's good. He doesn't have an Iron Bark, so. Oh, Soul of the Forest. It's also really good. Oh, Avenge. So let's hit. Avenge. And I think. Oh, okay. I can Aldor Peacekeeper this. Kill it. Okay, then recombobulate. Oh, that is so good! Oh my god, that is fantastic! Oh, that was so good! Oh my god, recombobulate, I love you. Let's hope it doesn't have a Moonfall! Oh no! Well, Moonfall, or Starfall, deals only with this and this. No, that still have to trade in both of these. Oh, that was such a. And then, even if it does that, I have Avenge. Oh, that's so good. Oh, that's good also for him. He can trade. He's gonna draw some cards. Oh, Avenge also. That's also really good. Hopefully, it hits this. Oh, I meant to hit the Imp Master, but it hit the Recon Bob. So now it's a 7-5. That's so much damage. Do I have lethal? 6 and 7. That would be 14? No, 13, 13. 15, 16, okay. I don't have lethal, no I don't.
Time waits for no one.
No, I have 19 damage on the board. I don't have to have lethal.
Do-do-do-dum, do-do-dum.
Silence? Oh, that sucks. He drew into silence. Oh, and Zombie Chang. Okay. Oh, Onyxia. Oh, Onyxia plus the fucking Stormwind champion would have been so good. So, so good. I'm gonna trade here. I'm definitely gonna trade. So, I'm thinking I'm gonna put this into this. This into this, and this into this. Or this to this, and this into this, and this into I mean, the Storm into the Cultmaster, the Recon Bulb into the thing, and this into that, so I can maximum board control, and then Onyxia. This is kind of useless then, I mean the Imp Master, since it won't spawn anything. But I don't have anything, that doesn't kill anything. Ugh. I'm gonna have to play Onyxia though. Okay, let's do this. Let's do this. Let's do this, and then Onyxia. Yeah, the Imp Master is kind of fucked, since it's not doing anything. But this is such a strong board. Again, it's again weak to Starfire, to Starfall. But since he didn't use it last turn, I doubt he has it. That Keeper of the Grove was so good for him, the Stormwind champion to be silenced. But now I have really good damage, I have board control. He's keeping cards in his hand, which I don't know what they are. Let's see. He has to play something. Oh, and I have lethal on the ward also, so he has to kill. This plus this plus this, I have lethal. That's 12. 18, that's 12. Let's make it 20. And then, yeah. Oh, now 23 damage. I don't have lethal anymore. Ugh. For no one. Come on, what are you gonna do? You have 8 mana. You're gonna shapeshift, kill probably one of these. And then what? For the Crusade. Bade in Flame. Okay, so let's see. Oh, Kazan, you are useless. The light does not discriminate. So do I want to pum pum and then hit face? I don't see a point in killing this. Or I could kill this since this is such a waste of a card now. Or I could hit that. But I have so much damage, I'm just gonna face. But first I'm gonna kill this. And then I'm gonna go face. I have so much damage. Even he has to kill pretty much everything. He has to kill all of these. He has to kill all of my minions on the left, besides this one ones. Since even Kazan kills him, or he heals himself. Or if a hero powers, then Kazan doesn't kill him, but you know. I can see. Okay, so, yeah. So we're 3-0, which is fantastic. Okay. So I think I played pretty well that game. Yeah, okay. I think that Wild Pyro into Seal of Light was the winning portion of the game. Okay. Also, the Recombobulator of Hogger, or the Guardian of Kings into Storm and Champion. I'm getting so much value from my Recombob. So we're 3-0. We're 23 minutes in. I don't think I can play another game without this being over 30 minutes. So I'm going to end off this part here. If you like this, let's learn. Leave a like, leave a comment, and see. And give, like I said, the last one, give me tips. Give me commentary on what I did wrong, what I could have done better. And yeah, if you have any questions, go ahead and ask me. But I want this to be like a learning experience for both me and you. Well, mostly me, since I'm not that great at the game. But yeah, I'm probably after this, like on the fourth win, we start losing, maybe. We'll see. We haven't faced any mages or other paladins, so we'll see. So I'll see you then, guys. Bye!